If you're looking for some vegan, gluten-free, allergy-friendly snacks that everybody will enjoy, stick around, because I've got you covered.
I want sunshine, I want rain, I want love, I want the pain. Cheer me up.
Hey guys, it is a Saturday here, and tomorrow we are hosting our friends, and we haven't seen them in a year and a half. They have 7 kids. They are vegan and gluten-free for health and eczema reasons for their kids, and we are just hosting them and gonna serve a bunch of snacks just in the afternoon. And I thought I might as well film what I'm making, show you guys some simple, easy recipes that are all kid-friendly, overall healthy, delicious, with some fun treats in there. So let's jump into the kitchen, and I will just show you some snack ideas in case you are hosting some friends that are vegan, gluten-free. I think these are all soy-free as well, or if you just need some fun, kid-friendly snacks. Let's jump in.
Whenever I'm hosting, I love to think about what I can make in advance so that I don't have as much to do the day my friends arrive. So I started by making these frozen banana Snickers pops, I guess you could say. To start, I whipped up this thick, naturally sweetened peanut butter spread with natural peanut butter, peanut flour, and a little bit of maple syrup. Next, I prepared a bunch of ripe bananas by cutting them in half vertically and then horizontally, and just place them on a parchment-lined baking sheet, or I love to use these silicone baking mats. And once I had those all prepped and ready to go, I took some of that peanut butter spread and smeared it on the top. I had a ton of peanut butter spread left over, and I ended up using them for homemade peanut butter cups, but you can really make the spread as thin or thick as you would like, so I just put that on all of my cut-up bananas. Next, I melted some dark chocolate, and I should have added a little bit of coconut oil to this to make it easier to drizzle on top, but I didn't have any. It still worked great. And you're just gonna drizzle this all over your peanut butter topped bananas, and then I added on some roasted chopped salted peanuts, stuck these in the freezer, and they turned into a delicious, frozen, healthy, kid-friendly treat that was devoured. Next up, I prepared a bunch of watermelon. I feel like this is just a classic kid-friendly fruit that most kids enjoy. So I just cut up a whole watermelon and I chilled it in the fridge starting the day before so that it could be nice and cold and refreshing. Another kid-friendly finger food are just plain chopped up veggies with a dip like hummus. I just shared a sauce video, or it's coming out soon, where I make my own hummus. I love to make my own hummus. It's so easy and you can adjust the flavors and spices. But I just cut up some cucumber and put some carrots on a plate and then paired this with my homemade hummus. Next up, I made another one of my favorite homemade sweet treats, which is kettle corn, and this also got devoured completely. To start, you want to line a baking sheet with some parchment paper or a silicone baking mat and have a bowl ready. Then you're going to heat some oil in a large saucepan and put a couple kernels in, and once they pop, you know the oil is hot and ready for popping the rest of the kernels. So I just removed those first three so that they wouldn't burn. I add in my popcorn and my sugar, stir this just so that the kernels get well coated, and then you're going to put the lid back on and carefully, without burning yourself, allow the rest of the popcorn kernels to pop while shaking the pan every 10 seconds or so, just so that the sugar or popcorn doesn't get stuck to the bottom and burn. And once the kernels stop popping and slow down, you're gonna quickly pour them out onto your lined baking sheet, sprinkle some salt over the top, and then allow the popcorn to cool until the sugar hardens and becomes crispy and caramelized.
That sound means it's good. All the sugar has hardened and gotten crispy. So easy to make. Your friends will love you. Definitely try out this recipe.
Next up, right before my friends arrived, I made some fresh guac, and I just make it really simply with super ripe avocados if I can, and then all I add is some lime or lemon juice, whichever one I have on hand, and garlic salt. And for some reason, this is just how I've been making it for a while now. I find it really kid-friendly, but if you want to jazz it up, you could add in some cilantro, fresh tomato, some pickled jalapeno, whatever you want. But this was also devoured and didn't last long. Also, whenever I'm hosting and making a lot of homemade snacks, I love to utilize some store-bought items as well. So I just paired this homemade guac with some store-bought tortilla chips and then also just poured some store-bought salsa into a bowl. I love to make my own homemade salsa, but I prioritized things like kettle corn and those frozen banana treats instead. So now that I have all of my snacks ready, I'm just plating everything. I pulled those frozen banana Snickers bites out of the freezer just before serving and would pop them back in the freezer if people took a break, but they honestly got entirely eaten up. But this just ended up being a great day with friends and such a good combo of snacks. We had refreshing fruit and those frozen banana treats, as well as some veggies and dip. And then a fancier but easy to make homemade sweet treat with the kettle corn.
Okay guys, all the food is ready and prepped and chilling in the fridge, and my friends are about to show up with all their kids, and we're so excited to see them, and I know they will enjoy the snacks and everything will probably be eaten because when you put out good food, it usually gets eaten. I hope you guys got some healthy, fun, vegan, gluten-free snack ideas from this video. Please let me know if you try any of them out. I'll be leaving all the recipes and information that you need down in the description box, so be sure to check that out. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe if you're not, so you don't miss the next video, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye!